rumors spreading round. And that takes its time. About to check outside the game. And you know what I'm talking about. Just let me know if you wanna go to that whole mile on the range. They got a lot of nice girls.
Kilometers downhill, and then the only way is up the Alpe d'Huez. Alberto Contador sits at the back of these four leaders here. They've begun the way down the Col de Galibier. If the roads look familiar, they should. The riders came up them yesterday to summit out the finish of yesterday's stage. And he wasn't freewheeling quite like that yesterday, was he? And that is Andy Schleck on the way down, getting as much as he can out of that bike without making the effort.
Well, most of these riders will know this descent because they actually rode back down it last night after the race finished. Schleck taking a few risks going around these corners. Schleck didn't ride down after the finish yesterday, Phil, because he stayed at the top of the mountain until about 7:30, having to wait to provide a medical sample for the doping control. Thomas Vogler, quite clever, came down with one of the motorbikes from the newspaper L'Equipe to get himself off the top of the mountain down to his team bus as quickly as possible.
Yeah, well, sometimes those little favours are very specially reserved for French riders, especially if you lead the Tour de France. There is now the chase back. This is Cadel Evans here in the centre of our picture. He's got to make the descent of his life now. He's got to bridge, according to our computer, 28 seconds to catch up with those four leaders. And I cannot see those four leaders holding off Cadel Evans now. Tom Danielson is in a group of riders, the best-placed American rider, of some seven riders, including Frank Schleck. And they are chasing down. We've got no time on them just now. The next group we have a time on is the yellow jersey at 1:42.
Well, I tell you what, Phil, the way this race has unfolded so far, if it all does come back together, it's going to be a massive sort out on the slopes of the Alpe d'Huez. It's going to be the last man standing, I think, who wins the Tour de France here this afternoon.
It has been all for one and one for all. It has been a terrific Tour de France. All of the favourites advertising their strength and always coming back together. Look at this now, Contador, absolutely superb in descent. Holds the middle of the handlebars. Now he reaches for those brakes as he leans into the corner and swings right. A lot of criticism on how these riders descend, especially coming to us from motorcyclists and racing car drivers. They never seem to line up correctly for the corners.
Well, the way to do it is to move over to the far side and then cut right across the apex of the corner. But the problem is, on a lot of these descents, Phil, some of the corners come too quickly for you to actually to line up properly to get into the next corner that comes up.
Well, apparently, if you can't see the other side when you go in, and it's tight. Four riders, and just behind Sanchez will be Hesjedal and Evans.
Well, this is the next group. This is the Evans group, and in that group you've got Heyerdahl and you've got Tommy Danielson, yeah. Also Arnaud Lejeunesson, the young Frenchman who's looking to try and get himself a crack at the white jersey, but the best placed rider in the white jersey competition, in fact, is Pierre Rolland.
Just look at this, Paul. This is the style of a man who used to be in charge of the mountain bike. He was the top mountain biker in the world. He twice won the World Cup, Cadel Evans. He can handle a bike as well as anybody and better than most. Now he's got to have to descend like a stone. He's got to contact the leaders.
Well, this is the group of Basso. Ivan Basso in the front in the lime green there with Jakob Fuglsang. And he's the rider from Team Leopard Trek. He's wearing number 13 upside down. A lot of riders are very suspicious. And that was always the number that used to be given to Fabian Cancellara. And he managed to get away from that.
Just picking up here, the back of the Radio Shack riders, Levi Leipheimer. This is the Maillot Jaune group. Leipheimer joined it on the way up, and he's going down with it right now. Just flashing through our screens there, too. It was one of the Sky riders. I think it was Geraint Thomas. I'm not sure. May have been wrong there. It is Geraint Thomas coming onto the back of the group.
Well, the big question a lot of people have been asking me, what is Geraint Thomas going to be in the sport of professional cycling? Is he going to be a classics rider, or is he going to be a Grand Tour rider? Sean Yates felt maybe he'd be more axed towards being a classics rider, but I think the way he's ridden through the mountains here over the last couple of days, Phil, I think we can start to dream about this guy being a Tour de France contender in the future.
Well, he's always distinguished himself. Now the computer sorting ebbing out at the moment. It's 12 seconds, the gap to Sanchez, to the leaders. There is a chasing group, as we've seen, and they're now officially saying they are 31 seconds back. And so there's plenty of time to close that. Those sort of gaps should be closed before we get to the... But he's fighting all the way. He still treasures hopes of rejoining the side of those leaders. This is the man who should get to them first. Samuel Sanchez looking right ahead there. Those cars are just behind that leading group of four. Officially, that gap is 12 seconds. Then you only need to look back 21 seconds and you will see that group containing...
Aching, the stripes seem to
Christmas card. It's not a healthy thing to do.
No, we're going around the Dutch corner there. You can see it's painted in orange, and they're dressed in orange today, not for the Basque supporters, but this is a little bit of Holland, and the crowd are going crazy.
This is Dutch corner, and they had hoped to be cheering Robert Hessing up to the lead here. He's had a terrible tour. The game crashes for him, so they're reserving their cheers now for Alberto Contador, and that'll be quickly followed by Andy Schleck, Cadel Evans, Frank Schleck, Riblon, Ryder Hesjedal is there, and Tommy Danielson has got himself back up here as well, the American, and also the little prince Damiano Cunego.
Well, he's done a great job, Tommy Danielson. A little tap on the shoulder there from Ryder Hesjedal, saying, look mate, I'm almost cooked here this afternoon. Now you stay in contact, because we could be laying the foundations down for the team victory for Team Garmin Cervelo of the United States. But this man is doing a phenomenal job, Alberto Contador. I don't think I've ever seen him suffer quite as much as he's doing here. He's got the pride of a nation on his shoulders, the pride of Spain.
24 seconds, it's back to Sanchez and Pierre Roland. 57 seconds back to the Schlecks and Cadel Evans. That's ironic, because 57 seconds is the difference between Andy Schleck and Cadel Evans in the overall classification. Advantage at the moment to Andy Schleck. The yellow jersey at 2 minutes and 45 seconds. An immense crowd at Dutch Corner. As many as we've ever seen, I think, Paul.
No, they actually queue up there for a couple of days to make sure they get it reserved for Holland. And you can see the Dutch flags waving nice and high. And if you ever fancy an all-night party, well, that's the place to go the day before the Tour de France actually comes to finish on the Alpe d'Huez.
Now, Contador, now who started the day 4:39 behind Andy Schleck, is now 3 minutes 30 behind him in the overall classification at the current time gains. He won't take 3:30 back off Andy Schleck in the time trial, so he's got to push on. They are fighting to save the Tour de France behind him and stop last year's champion getting it. As we look here now, the face of Samuel Sanchez trying to race for not what would be double points today in the King of the Mountain. Might well swing the King of the Mountains back in his favour with 40 points at the finish, but little matter of Alberto Contador is up ahead of him. This is Frank Schleck again taking over. Cadel Evans just closes his mouth and grits his teeth and grips the two wheels. Now let's go to back to...